I was an assistant manager at a bagel shop in Kingston, Pennsylvania. We had a very affluent customer base. And at 6 a.m. every morning, the madness started. People would just mob the shop. There was one customer that I would make eye contact with as he came in. His name was Ned. And I would know when he looked at me that he wanted his regular order, which was an everything bagel, toasted with regular cream cheese, but lightly spread to go. How many years later, and I can still remember that. What I couldn't get is why my employees couldn't remember that. Or why, when they were seeing him walk in the door, they weren't prepping his meal. Most of our customers came in the same day, the same time, ordered the same thing. I got madder and madder by the day. And so then, of course, I said, that's it. Management by intimidation. And I called them all an idiot in front of everybody. Shortly after that, we had a lot of turnover. I couldn't figure out why. It took me a long time, 15 years, to realize that I was part of the problem. And the only reason I realized it was because I had a mentor who talked to me in a manner that didn't put me on the defense. And that meant the world to me. And it made me change. I've come a long way. I have a long way to go. I screw up daily. But I'm quicker to make amends and say I'm sorry and move on. We're all a work in progress, right? Don't you wish that you had the guts to say, dear leader, you might be part of the problem? I want everybody to close their eyes, just so nobody else can see who raised their hands, and raise your hand if you want to have the guts to say, dear leader, you might be part of the problem. Okay, you can open your eyes and put your hands down.